Good afternoon, students. In the previous class, we have completed exercise 13.1 of chapter exponents and powers. So today we will discuss the laws of exponents. Okay, laws of exponents. Let a comma b are non-zero integers and m comma n are whole numbers. Then first law is e to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n. That is multiplying powers with the same base. Here the bases are same, but the powers are different. We see that here the bases are same, but the powers are different. Therefore, the rule is multiplying powers with the same base. For example, 2 square into 2 cube. Here we see that the bases are same, but the powers are different. Now, 2 square. Here the power of 2 is 2. So we write 2 2 times. And here the power of 2 is 3. So we write 2 3 times. Therefore, this is equal to 2 to the power 5. Since here 5 times 2. Okay, here 2 is 5 times, so this is equal to 2 to the power 5, that is 2 to the power 3 plus 2. Therefore, a to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n. Here m is equal to 2, n is equal to 3 and a is equal to 2. Again I repeat, let a is any non-zero integers and m comma n are whole numbers. Then first law is multiplying powers with the same base. Here the bases are same, but the powers are different. And law is a to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n. For example, 2 square into 2 cube. Now comparing, we see that a is equal to 2, m is equal to 2, n is equal to 3. Here the bases are same, but the powers are different. Since the power of 2 is 2, so we write 2 2 times, and here the power of 2 is 3, so we write 2 3 times. Now here 2 is 5 times, so this is equal to 2 to the power 5. This is equal to 2 to the power 3 plus 2, that is a to the power m plus n. And next rule is a to the power m divided by a to the power n is equal to a to the power m minus n. Again I repeat, a to the power m divided by a to the power n is equal to a to the power m minus n. That is dividing powers with the same base. Here the powers are different, but the bases are same. And here m greater than n. M must be greater than n. Again I repeat the law, a to the power m divided by a to the power n is equal to a to the power m minus n, and here m greater than n. For example, 3 to the power 4 divided by 3 to the power 3. Here the power of 3 is 4, so we write 3 4 times, and here the power of 3 is 3, so we write 3 3 times. Therefore, we get this is equal to 3 to the power 1, since there is 1, 3, and this is equal to 3 to the power 4 minus 3. Here a is equal to 3, that is base, m is equal to 4 and n is equal to 3, and the answer is a to the power m minus n, and here m greater than n. Again, I repeat the law. If a is any non-zero integers and m and n are whole numbers and m greater than n, then a to the power m divided by a to the power n is equal to a to the power m minus n. Here m greater than n. For example, 3 to the power 4 divided by 3 to the power 3. If we compare this law, if we compare with this law, we get a is equal to 3, m is equal to 4, and n is equal to 3. And here m greater than n. Now 3 to the power 4 is equal to 3 into 3 into 3 into 3, and 3 cube is equal to 3 into 3 into 3, that is 3 to the power 1, and therefore this is equal to 3 to the power 4 minus 3. Okay. And the next law is taking power of a power, that is a to the power m whole to the power n is equal to a to the power m into n. Here a is any non-zero integers and m, n are whole numbers. Again I repeat the law. A is any non-zero integers, m and n are whole numbers, then a to the power m whole to the power n is equal to a to the power m into n. The power will be a to the power m into n. For example, 2 cube whole square. Since the power of 2 cube is 2, we write 2 cube 2 times, that is 2 cube into 2 cube. Now compare, or from the law, a to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n. A to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n. Using this law, a to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n, we get 2 to the power 3 plus 3. Using the law, a to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n, that is law 1. Using the law 1, we get 2 to the power 6, and this is equal to 2 to the power 3 into 2. We can write 6 as 3 into 2. Again, I repeat the law. The third law is taking power of a power. If a is any non-zero integers and m, n are whole numbers, then a to the power m whole to the power n is equal to a to the power m, n. Okay. For example, 2 cube whole square. This is equal to 2 cube into 2 cube. Now using the law, a to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n, that is law 1. A to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n, because here the bases are same. So this is equal to 2 to the power 3 plus 3. This is equal to 2 to the power 6. This is equal to 2 to the power 3 into 2. Okay. And next law is, if a, b are non-zero integers and m, n are whole numbers, then a to the power m into b to the power m is equal to a, b whole to the power m. That is multiplying powers with the same exponents. Here we see that the bases are different, but the powers are same. Here we see that the bases are different, but the powers are same. For example, 2 square into 3 square. Here the power of 2 is 2, so we write 2 times. And here the power of 3 is also 2, so we write 3 2 times. Now we write it as 2 into 3 into 2 into 3, and this is equal to 6 into 6, and therefore this is equal to 6 square, that is 2 into 3 whole square, isn't it? That is 2 into 3